So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can reply to any message which is being sent in a group to a bot. Okay, so in my previous video, I have shown you how you can create a bot and using that bot, how you can automatically send messages. And this video was created almost, 7-8 months ago, and which is already been watched by quite a lot of people. And this video which is I'm creating today, it is creating on the request which is sent by blessed data wanted to know, is it possible to reply based on whatever the conversation is going on in the group. Okay, so you may want to reply based on a couple of words or based on any search criteria, and then you can take lots of different type of action based on whichever word which you find. And this came almost 2 months ago, and then yesterday I saw another reply on this. Then I thought, okay, I'm just gonna create a video on this. So by the way, if you haven't really subscribed as of now, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Channel name is Vikas Jha. You can search in YouTube, and this is the name of the channel. Now let's talk a bit about process of creating Telegram bot. Even though I have already created process in this video, but I thought just gonna explain it again, so it's going to be better if somebody is watching this as a standalone video. Okay. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, if you want to create a bot, you need to first search for Botfather. So go ahead and search for Botfather, then it's gonna open up Botfather, and here you need to tell Botfather to create a bot for you. So for example, here you need to start by writing slash and new bot. Okay, so it is saying, all right, a new bot, how are we going to call it? Please choose a name for your bot. So it's asking what is the name you want to give to your bot. So I'm just gonna call it YouTube demo and click on send. Then it's saying, good, now let's choose a username for your bot. So I'm just gonna call it YouTube_demo_bot. Just make sure whatever username you give, it is ending with underscore bot. Okay, click on send, and it's quickly gonna check whether this username is available. If it is available, it is going to return the token, token for you. Okay, so this is a token which is identifying that this token belongs to this username, which is YouTube_demo_bot. Never ever share this API with anyone, because then that person will be able to take total control of this bot. So now we have learned how to create a bot. Okay, now before we move any further, I just wanted to let you know that if you want to get information about your bot, you can just write a small Python program. So here what I have done is I'm just gonna move on to the Python program. So I'm going to explain it to you. Okay, but before that, I'm just gonna comment everything, and let's focus here on line by line. So first of all, here we have token, which is token of my previous bot which I had created before making this video. So I'm just gonna delete it, and we are going to copy this new token which we have received, copy it, and we are gonna paste it. And also at this moment, you just need this library, which is a requests library. That's going to be enough. And we have created a variable which is called token. We assigned a token to it. Okay, so now what we are gonna do is we are just gonna use this token name here. So if you want to get information regarding bot, this is the API you need to call, and you need to, after bot, you need to write this token. But we are assigning this this token to a variable, and then here we are going to use this variable. So this is a this is Python syntax. I know many of you already know Python, so you would be already aware of how this works. But if you don't know about Python, I will really suggest that you go ahead and learn basics of Python, and that's going to be very useful and going to help you in doing lots and lots of different type of automation. Now we are gonna do a response request and gonna call it request.get, and here we need to specify the URL. Okay, base URL. By the way, before even we do it, I'm just gonna comment it, and let's print this base_URL. This tutorial, by the way, is gonna be a little longer because I'm going to explain everything, so there is no confusion. And if you just want to jump onto some specific part, then I'm gonna give the timeline in this video. You can jump to that specific part, but it's going to be very useful if you just watch it completely, and it's gonna be quite useful because I'm going to share lots and lots of tips in this. Now that's it. I'm gonna run it. Let's see what we get. Okay, so if we run it, this is what we get. Okay, this is actually the API which we get. Okay, along with the token. So what I will do is let's run this here, and you will notice what is the output it gives us. So if I just run it here, on this browser, this is the output which we get. So it is giving us information about this bot. It is saying the ID of this bot is this one, and it is also telling whether this is a bot. So yes, it is a bot. So that's why you see the value here is true. And here also you can get information about what is the first name of this bot, which is YouTube demo. This is the name which we gave it to. And then username is YouTube demo bot. So if you remember, these are all the details which we gave it to, which is fine. So at any point of time, if you want to know, your bot information, you can just replace this. Okay, you can replace this with your token, and you can run the same API here. But we are not going to do this by running one by one here on the browser. We are just gonna do everything programmatically using Python. So now I'm gonna uncomment this line, and this line is going to do the same thing which we did here. Okay, so here we did it manually. Now here Python is going to do us for us, and then we are just gonna remove this. I'm gonna print response.txt. Okay, and run it. Let's see what is the output we get. So you see, this is the same output which we have received, which we saw here. Also, if you just see below this, there is a program which I was just practicing, and I have just kind of created some more advanced program. I'm not gonna go into detail of that. So just gonna insert couple of blank rows here, okay, blank cells, so we can just focus here. Okay, so as of now, you have learned how to create a bot and how you can get details about the bot. Now other thing which we are going to do is if you want to see, if you want to know details about whatever is being sent in a group, in that case you need to make sure that you add your bot in the group. Now here we are going to create a group. For that I'm gonna go to Telegram, create new group, and here we need to add members. We need to select the members which we want to add in the group. So here, let's say I'm gonna add our bot, which is called YouTube_demo_bot. Okay, so I'm gonna select it, go to next, and here we can give the name to the group. So I'm gonna give it name of YouTube_demo_group. You can give any name you want. This is the name I'm giving it, and gonna click on create. Okay, so now this is a group which we have created. Now notice one thing, I'm just gonna go to next URL, which is called, if you see here, the API remains the same. Most of the things remain the same. The only thing which changes is this one here. We were writing get me. Now here we are gonna write get updates, which is going to give us updates of any chat which is being written in the group. Now we don't need this one, so we are just going to comment it. Okay, this is being commented, and now I'm gonna move on to here. And also let's do one thing. I'm just gonna do response equal to, or we can just copy from here as well. Okay, don't worry, I'm gonna give the code to you as well, so you don't really need to type everything. Just need to understand here properly, and then you'll be able to use it. Now here I'm gonna say print response.txt, and then let's run it and see what is the output which we get. Okay, so this is the output which we have received if you run get updates. And notice one thing, you don't really need to run this get updates here. You can do the same way which we did previously. So you can write base_URL, and then you are going to see the complete URL. So this get updates URL, you can use it here on the browser as well. If you run it, it's gonna give you this kind of output. So let's try to understand the output. And here you see, if this is giving us all the updates. So the first update was about, this was the first output update, which was telling us about, whatever the thing which has happened so far, like creation of the user account, creation of the group and all, and how this bot being added to the group. Okay, so all of those detail is available here. Now let's do one thing. let's write. I'm writing here using my own ID, okay, so which is Vikas Jha. So here I'm gonna write hello. Let's write hi, how are you, and hit enter, and let's run it. I'm gonna run this Python program, and let's see whether we got that update or not. Okay, so here if you notice, we haven't really got that update. I'm gonna do the same thing here, run it, and if you notice, it is still the same. We have not received any update. The reason for that is because when you create a bot, it is kind of, you know, created in a secured way, so you won't get any update. So we need to set privacy of this bot. Okay, so we are gonna go to bot father again, and here we are going to write we are gonna give command, and we are gonna say set privacy. Okay, so search for set privacy, and then it is going to ask you which is the bot in which you want to make changes. So these are all the bots which I have. So the one in which we want to make changes is YouTube demo bot, and then it is telling us that current status is enabled. Notice here, if the status is enabled, your bot will only receive messages that either start with slash symbol or mention the bot by username. So for example, as per our current status, if any message is being sent using, you know, slash in the beginning, in that case our bot will be able to see those messages, but any other messages our bot will not be able to see. So for example, in this case, let's go back to our example here. Okay, so in this case, let's say I'm gonna send a new message starting from slash and gonna say hi, how are you, and now let's run the same thing. I'm gonna run it, and now you will notice that we have received this message, okay, which is saying hi, how are you. Okay, so our bot is currently, you know, set privacy is set to disabled. That is why it is only going to read any message which is starting with slash or it is mentioning a bot. Okay, so here also if I run this Python program, it is gonna give us, you know, the same output. Here you can see it is giving us, you know, the line which is starting with slash. Okay, so this is not what we want. We rather want to see all the messages which is being sent in this group, and in that case we need to go to bot father and we need to disable privacy. So here it is saying it is enabled. Now we are gonna change it to disabled. So for that we are select disable here, and it is going to say success, the new status is disabled. Okay, now if you run this program again, it is not going to show you all the older messages because it only takes effect from the new sent messages. So if any new message is being sent in this group, which is YouTube demo, okay, so if a new message being sent in this group, now it's gonna read everything. So I'm gonna say hello, hit enter, and then you can run the same Python program, and notice here in the last line we have this text which is called hello. Okay, so what it means is now your bot is able to read any conversation which is going on here in the group. And notice also one thing, just gonna actually copy it and going to paste it here on JSON formatter so you understand what is the structure of this message, because now we need to programmatically fetch every detail from this structure. Okay, so this is the data which we receive, which is being received in a JSON format. And here if you just scroll down, you can see this is the message which we have received. This was from my oldest output, so I'm just gonna close it, clear it, and we can just focus on this one. Okay, so this is a message, this is the result which we got when we executed Python program. And now you notice here is this is the structure which we have. So in response we get result, and under result we have all the data. So if here you can see we have four line items. So if we expand it one by one, you can see that we have update ID, which is a unique update ID. So whatever update you get in a bot, that is going to have a unique update ID, and it is being incremented. Okay, so at any point of time, if you want to know which is the update ID which you want to reply to, you can see from here. But anyway, we are not gonna use it. Now here if you see, there are different types of updates which is happening here. So the one which we are interested in is the one which came almost in the end. So here if you see, we have let's see what we have got. We have got message, and under message we have message ID. We have from that this message was being sent from, you know, Vikas Jha with the username Vikas Jha 001 with the ID of this. So we have information about, you know, the user who sent us the message. Then we have information about, you know, the chat ID, which is the, you know, name of the group, ID of the group and name of the group and all those things. Here it is telling us whether it is a group or it is not a group. So if in the type you see group, it means this message is being sent in a group. Notice here when you run this get update, it is going to give you all the updates. So any action which has happened to the bot, it is going to give us all the detail. And you can differentiate by, you know, you seeing in type. And now here in text we have a text which was being sent, okay, which is hello. Now if you just minimize it and you see the previous message, in the previous message we had written slash hi, how are you? So you have that message as well. Okay, if I let's say add more messages, so I'm gonna say how are you doing these days. Okay, hit enter and let's run this program. So here you see we have new message, and I'm just gonna copy it, paste it here on JSON formatter, click on process, and now here you have updated message. So here now we should have 5 line items. So you can see we have 5 line items, and this is the latest message which we sent, which says hi, which says how are you doing these days. Okay, so now you understood the whole structure of this event. Now we are going to use Python program to, you know, get the data from this JSON structure, and then we are going to reply to the user. Now before that, about the send message, I have already, you know, explained everything here in this video, so I'm not going to go into much detail about how we are sending message, but I'm going to give you all the key information which you need. So first thing is, we don't need all of these here, okay, so just gonna remove it. And now I'm gonna uncomment everything. This is the code which I had written. Now if you see, I'm just gonna quickly explain this code to you. So for example, here what we are doing is, we are calling get updates, okay, here we are calling get updates, and then we are making a get request, and whatever the data which we are getting, we are converting that data to JSON, because if you convert your data to JSON, it's going to be very easy for you to, you know, traverse or navigate through all the text. And then we are saying for item in data result, so all the items, is a for loop which is going to look into all the items which is under result. Okay, as you know that our data is under result, so we are going to look through everything which is under result. And then I have just written a try and accept block. So if there is any error, we just, you know, don't, we are just passing it, so we are not really doing much. So we don't want this program to fail. If there is any error, it's gonna go to accept block and then it's gonna continue again. Now here notice one thing, what I have done is, item under item messages entity zero type equal to mention. So if you notice, typically in a group, there can be, you know, lots of messages which might be going on. So let's say you have a group of 100 or 200 group members. In that case, a lot of people are going to, you know, talk to each other, and you don't really want to, you know, be notified, or you don't want to reply to messages which is not being sent to you. So what I'm doing is, I am only checking the message which is mentioning our bot. So for example, if there is a message which is called, let's say, how are you, and which is mentioning our bot like this, okay, and click on send, let's see what is the output we get if we run it. So here I'm gonna run it again. Now notice here, this is the output which we have got, and I'm just gonna use it in JSON formatter again, process it, and now let's see the output. So it should be in the last line. Okay, so here in the last line, now you see we have message which is how are you, and the name of the bot which is mentioning our bot. So whenever you see any username or any bot name being mentioned in a chat, in that case we are also going to have one more entry which is telling us entities, and in the under the entities in the type we are going to have mention. Okay, so how you will reach to this path, by using this. So you need to write item, messages, entities, zero type equal to mention. Okay, so we are checking if we are only interested in the messages which is mentioning, okay, which is having mention keyword, okay, which is having type as mention. And then if you want, you can print the item. So any message which is having type equal to mention, I'm printing that. And then I have created variables, which is chat ID, user ID, username, and message. These are things which we are interested in. Chat ID is required to know, you know, which from which group the message has been received. For example, typically there may be chances that your the bot which you have created is part of, you know, multiple groups. So in that case, you can know from which group the message has come by using chat ID. Okay, chat ID is actually going to be a unique identifier of, you know, the group. So for example, this chat ID belongs to this group, YouTube demo group. If your user is added in multiple groups, you will receive multiple IDs. You will see different IDs here, and all those IDs are going to be unique. Okay, so that's why I have used chat ID here, and next is user ID. So I'm grabbing user information. So I'm grabbing this ID, which is user ID. Okay, so under from, I'm going to ID. So if you see here, we are going to messages, then we are going to from, then we are going to ID, okay, which is giving us user ID. For chat ID, we went to messages, then we went to chat, then we are using ID, which is giving us chat ID. Now to get the username, we need to go to messages, then we need to go to from, then we need to go to username. So you can see the same thing here. So to get the username, we had to go to, you know, we had to go to messages. So here you see messages, and under messages we had to go to from, and under from we have username. So this is the structure of JSON, and based on that, first I checked it here, and based on that I use this. And to get the message, you need to go to message text. If you just go here, you will see your message is here, text. Okay, so your message is under message. Under message you have several items, but you are focusing on text, which is having the actual message name. So all the four important things which we needed, we are printing it here. And now you're going to see the part which you wanted me to let you know. Okay, so for example, in this video you wanted to know, is it possible to reply based on couple of words. So if you see here, what I'm doing is I'm actually checking whether message contains a word which is called hi. Okay, you can check for any messages. If you want, you can check for multiple messages as well. But I'm not gonna go through everything in this video, otherwise really gonna be very, very long. So I'm just gonna, you know, I'm giving all the important information. Here I'm just gonna look for one word which is called hi, or let's keep it, let's change it to salamat pagi. Okay, this is good morning, or I'm just gonna change it to pagi. This is good morning in Indonesia, Bahasa Indonesia. So I'm gonna search whether this message pagi contains in the message or not. So if anyone is, you know, writing this message, in that case what I'm doing is I'm going to reply by this line. I'm gonna write, hi, how are you doing, do let me know if you need any help. Okay, and notice here I'm using parse mode as HTML. In my previous video I haven't really used parse mode as HTML, but in this case, since we also want to mention the username while replying, because there can be, you know, many people who are writing pagi in the group, and you want to reply to each user by mentioning their username. So that's the reason I'm using parse mode as HTML, because if you don't use parse mode as HTML, then you won't be able to mention any username. So here, if you see, I have created a variable which is called text, and under that I'm writing all the text which I want. And this is the syntax of mentioning a username. So here, this is the default syntax. And after ID, you need to give ID. So ID, if you see here, we have already stored user ID here in user ID variable. So here I'm giving format as user ID, which is going to replace user ID here. I'm gonna put user ID here, and this username gonna be put here. So what this is gonna do is this is gonna mention username. And this will be a lot clearer when I show you the output. Now here is the to URL. To URL is basically the URL which is which is being used to send messages. Now here also, if you notice, in all the URLs we are using bot key. So here is the token or the key which we need to give, and after that we are writing send message. So earlier I had shown you get me, and I had shown you get updates, and this is send message. This is the one which you need to use when you are going to reply. And also notice here we are replying only to a particular group, so that's why we have mentioned here chat ID, and that's the reason we also grabbed chat ID here. Okay, so we have the chat ID, we have text which you want to write. So this is the text which I want to write, and that's all basically you need. And I'm giving all of these information by passing all of these three variables. Okay, and then we are just gonna making a request.get which is going to send this message. Now let's run it, and I'm not gonna print anything here, so let me disable anything if we have printed anything. So yeah, I'm not gonna print anything. I'm just gonna print a last line which is gonna say program ended posted message, or let's just gonna say program ended. Okay, now I'm gonna run it, and you notice it is saying program ended. Let's go to the group and see what has happened. If you notice here, nothing has happened. We didn't get any message. Okay, now as I mentioned you that, as I told you that, we don't want to reply to any message. We only want to reply to the message where we see word which is called Pagi. Okay, and also where our bot name has been mentioned. So for example, first I'm just gonna write Pagi and hit enter, and then going to run this program again, and let's see if anything happens in this case. So if you see here, nothing is happening again, because we have written Pagi in this group, but we haven't mentioned this bot name. Okay, so now this time I'm gonna write Pagi, and gonna also mention bot name, which is this YouTube demo bot. Okay, and this time let's run it, and now if we run this program, it should actually go on and post this message, and also gonna link to the user. So I'm just gonna run it, and let's see now. Okay, so here you see, now you see bot has replied. So this person, which is my email ID, which is my user account from Telegram, so this can be any person. This person is writing Pagi, mentioning a word, and writing it to this bot, and then this bot is immediately replying by, hi, how are you doing, do let me know if you need any help. Okay, so this is just one way of parsing any message and then replying to that user. If you want, you can do lots of different things. For example, if you are an admin in the group, in that case, let's say you don't really want people to be writing bad words in the group. So if anyone writes any F word or S word or any word which you don't want to be in the group, in that case you can look for that word, here in if, and then you can take some action, such as banning the user or kicking the user out from the group, or you can just send a warning message that don't write this message again, otherwise you are going to get kicked out of the group. So there are lots of different kind of actions which can be taken in this situation. So this program is actually already, this video actually gonna be very long, so I'm just gonna stop it here. And in the next video, I'm gonna add how you can kick a user out based on if that user is writing anything in the group or the user is sending any links. Hopefully I answered the question which was asked by Blessed Data and also Tho Wen Hui. And thank you so much for commenting here and letting me know the queries. So if you have any queries in this new video, do let me know here as well. I'm just gonna reply to you, to all of you. I try to reply to as much as many people as I can. And if you also have any genuine request, if you want to learn something, do let me know in the comment section. I'm gonna reply you and gonna probably create a video if that requires more detail or more attention. Now one thing, if you see here, I have already created a this group, and I have also shown you bot ID. So that's why I'm gonna go to bot father and gonna delete the bot. We need to write yes, I'm totally sure, so I'm gonna write it. Okay, yeah, so we have got the reply done, the bot is gone. Okay, which means the bot has been successfully deleted. Okay, so that's the reason I shown you the API key, because I knew I'm gonna delete this bot, but for God's sake, never ever share your token ID. It's very, you know, it's confidential. Keep it only to yourself. So see you again in the next video. Please do not forget to subscribe if you like all the videos related to Python and Telegram automation.